So this is kind of what we're after, these fine bark fibers right here. Come off in big strips, make easy to make cordage. Brought my obsidian dagger that I made. And a deer pouch. This is actually going to go in a quiver that I'm making. Go ahead and we're going to climb up here and cut us some more of this bark. So we have enough fibers now for this project. This will be for the bigger pieces. Now we're going to go get some more cordage from a smaller plant. Otzi Scabbard, he used dry grass and some tree fibers to make his. So I just sat here and tried with this dead grass, and it twists up a decent piece of cordage. And it's tough. So gonna collect some of the longer ones. I'm gonna keep looking and see if I can find the other bark I was talking about. But so here's the next plant that I was talking about. Snap them at the base. So breaking these, you can pull off the fibers. Even if they're not super long, you can still use them to make cordage. I'll show you guys here in a few. So now we're going to take our different fibers and we're going to twist these up into some cordage. Start twisting these. Twist it and lock it into place over the other. Twist, lock. So when you either come up on the end of it or you start running out and it starts getting thinner, take you some more and you want to put it right up in there. Split the sides with these ones and pinch them together and continue to twist your cordage. And also, if it starts getting thick after you get it twisted, you can just
tear off some and continue to twist. So I got the pieces all braided up. You know, for this project, you'll need 8 1-foot long pieces. And then here's another longer rope that I made. Might end up using this. We'll see here in a minute. But what we want to do is take a flame and go through and singe off all them pieces hanging off of here.